I'm just starting with the example of a Muslim of Qur'an.
For a Muslim who has got great ambitions to go beyond his own limitation, for a Muslim who is trying to go beyond their own limitation and try to overcome the obstacles. Well, I was not able to see the Prophet. I'm not officially considered a companion, but I will still be able to compete the companions and to do as good as they did to be able to be in the company of the Prophet ﷺ in the hereafter. This example is for us as well to think carefully about our situation, our status in terms of our relationship with the Prophet ﷺ and with the companions. We are not companions, we are not tabi'un, we are tabi'ut tabi'un. We are just ordinary Muslims. And I am mentioning this example in the context of the Hijrah, as we are still breathing the odor of Al-Hijrah and Al-Nabawiyyah al-Sharifa, to see if it is still possible for us, as ordinary Muslims, to share the reward of Hijrah just as the companions did with the Prophet ﷺ. Is it still possible? And the answer is yes, just as it was possible for the Muslim al-Qur'an to compete the companions, it's still possible for us to compete them and to share the reward of Hijrah. Yes, we already missed being in the company of the Prophet ﷺ on the journey of Hijrah. But we shouldn't miss out being in the company of the Prophet ﷺ and competing his companions in our journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the main thing I would like to touch on today. Yes, it's still possible to compete the Sahaba. How can we compete the Sahaba? How can we be Muhajirun, for example? They did Hijrah, how can we do it? The Prophet ﷺ opened the door for every Muslim to share the reward of Hijrah. And this is a very simple thing. He said, Al-Muhajiru man hajara ma naha Allah anhu. The true Muhajir, the true migrant, is the one who stays away from whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden. Simple as. It's not something that you should do, but rather something that you shouldn't do. You shouldn't do the ma'asi, you shouldn't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You shouldn't go beyond the limits posed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this way, you will be sharing the reward of the hijrah. Al-muhajiru man hajara ma naha Allah. And though it sounds to be simple and easy, but still there is a bit of a challenge about it. Because al-ma'asi, disobedience of Allah azza wa jal, is always attractive, and that's the test from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala wants life to be a bit challenging, in order to differentiate between the good people and the bad ones. Those who deserve the mercy and paradise of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and those who deserve the punishment to Allah. Because unfortunately, there are some Muslims who, for example, trade in alcohol, alcoholic drinks. And then they say, okay, I'm going to give sadaqah or whatever to get rid of that sin. Others violate other people's rights, material rights or moral rights, and then they think it's as simple as going for hajj. Let me go for hajj or do umrah, and in this way I'll get rid of the sin. Actually, to get rid of a sin, you have to leave it altogether. That's the only way. Al-muhajiru man hajara ma naha Allahu anhu. Even if it's a recurrent theme, something that you're in the habit of doing it, at least make sure you do tawbah, you do sincere tawbah every time you do it. Whenever you make a mistake, whenever you commit a sin that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely and show repentance, show that you regret it, that you feel sorry for what happened, and you are making up your mind that you'll never go back to the sin again. At least in this way, your tawbah, inshallah, will be acceptable, even if you, later on, due to any point of weakness, you go back to do it again. لو لم تذنبوا لأتى الله بقوم يذنبون ثم يستغفرون الله فيغفر الله عز وجل لهم. If you don't do repentance of the mistakes or the sins that you are committing, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace you with other people who will still make mistakes and commit sins, but they will do tawbah. Tawbah makes a big difference. A person who commits sins, and obviously every human being is liable to commit mistakes, but the one who commits mistakes but goes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and repents, these are more likely to be accepted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إنما التوبة على الله للذين يعملون السوء بجهالة ثم يتوبون من قريب. من قريب. Allah's repentance is due to the people who make mistakes, who commit sins, but they just go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala straight away, without delay. That's the big difference. وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات. See the difference. وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن. Tawbah is not due for those who continue to make mistakes and commit sins until the last moment, until the moment of dying. And so only then they would say, إني تبت الآن. Now I repent, now I ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should ask forgiveness all the time. So to say that you should stay away from the sins doesn't necessarily mean that you shouldn't make it at all. It's better, of course. As Imam al-Hasan al-Basri used to say, إِنَّ تَرْكَ الْمَعْصِيَةَ أَكْثَرُ مِنْ تَوْبَةَ. تَرْكَ الْمَعْصِيَةَ أَيْسَرُ مِنْ تَرْكَ التَوْبَةَ. To avoid disobedience, to avoid the sin altogether, from the beginning, that's even better and easier than asking for forgiveness later, than making the sin and then asking for forgiveness. But yes, if you already done the sin, if you already disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course you have to repent. You have to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in the first place, you should think carefully about it before going to commit the sin, before thinking about disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think carefully about the consequences, about the outcome resulting from that. If you have a moment to think about it, I think you will avoid lots and lots and loads of sins. And that's what the Prophet ﷺ wants us to do. Al-Muhajiru man hadara ma'nahu Allahu anhu. Imagine the reward that you're going to get. It's not just by staying away from the sins and from disobedience, you're not just going to be able to get the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is something marvelous. But you will be rewarded an equal reward to that of the Sahaba who migrated with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine how much effort and how much sacrifice these people did. They left everything behind. They migrated the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They left their homeland, their properties, their wealth. Some of them left their families even, and they just went with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, looking for a safer environment to practice their Islam and to spread it around. Imagine you will be considered nearly on a footing of equality with these people, with the Sahaba, with the migrants. السابقون الأولون. These are the forerunners, the pioneers of Islam. السابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from those who followed them on the straight path. والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. So if you manage to follow these forerunners, the footsteps of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one way or another will be in a competition with them. So the more effort you make, the greater the reward you get. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us all and to help us share the reward and the benefits of Hijrah with the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله على نعمة الإيمان به وشرف الإسلام له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له القائم على كل نفس بما كسبت والمجازي لها بما عملت وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله سيد الداعين إلى الله على بصيرة والمجاهدين فيه بإحسان اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. Dear respected brothers and sisters, given that we are now in a competition with the companions of the Prophet, imagine the hard task that we are intended to do, a very important question arises. And I think most of you have got this question scratching in your minds. How can we compete, the companions of the Prophet, while there is nearly no room for any comparison between us and them? They are the people who sacrificed everything, and we're just doing very little compared to them. And the answer is that the Prophet ﷺ himself already involved us in such a comparison, in such a comparison. The Prophet ﷺ, as was reported by Imam Ahmad in Hadith Abi Jum'ata radiallahu anhu, said, one day kunna taghaddayna yawman ma'a Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ma'ana Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah. One day we had lunch with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and one of the people attending was Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah. And you know who Abu Ubaidah is? Abu Ubaidah is Amin al-Ummah, that the Prophet ﷺ used to label him. He used to call him al-Amin or Amin al-Ummah, like the secretary general of Ummat al-Habib Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And because they were enjoying the moment, having lunch with the Prophet ﷺ, so they thought of themselves to be the best people ever. So Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يا رسول الله هل أحد خير منا أسلمنا معك وجاهدنا معك. And they started counting the good things that they have done. And said, Ya Allah's Messenger, do you think there are any people better than us, better than the people who accompanied the Prophet, who embraced Islam very early and who accepted to sacrifice everything, and who did jihad, the fight in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to defend Islam and to defend their own country with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Are there any people better than us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes. أُنَاسٌ يَأْتُونَ بَعْدَكُمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِي وَلَمْ يَعُونَ. There are some people who will follow you, will come after you. They will believe in me without seeing me. That's the difference between us and them. And the Prophet ﷺ seems to be trying to raise our morale, our aspirations, to get engaged in that competition. You shouldn't give up. You shouldn't belittle yourself and think that, oh, these people are very far above our standards. Of course they are. They are very great people. I'm not belittling them at all. But I'm just highlighting the importance of not belittling ourselves, of aspiring for Allah's mercy, of having optimism and positive energy to reach up and up and more and more. قال أناس يأتون بي يأتون بعدكم يؤمنون بي ولن يروني. They will believe in me without seeing me, because you, as companions, believed me after seeing me. You saw me, you enjoyed my company, you listened to the Quran from me, you attended sessions, some of them, in which the Quran was being revealed. I was being revealed to, and you sat next to me. That was very miraculous. So you had more incentive to believe. But there are people, for them, I'll be something like, I'll be someone unseen. And Nabi بالنسبة لنا غير. We never saw, seen the Prophet ﷺ. So we believe in the Prophet ﷺ as part of our iman, or our belief in al-ghayb, in the unseen, just like paradise, just like whatever, the angels. We never seen the angels, and we never seen the Prophet ﷺ. And this is the credit that the Prophet ﷺ had given to us, as people who believed in Allah and His Messenger without even seeing the Messenger ﷺ. The other thing was highlighted in another narrative, in another hadith, in which the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ وَرَاءَكُمْ أَيَّامَ الصَّبْرِ. They will come after you the days of patience. The days of patience mean that these days will require more effort. For you to be a proper Muslim, you have to be more patient. إِنَّ وَرَاءَكُمْ أَيَّامَ الصَّبْرِ الْمُتَمَسِّكُ فِيهِنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِمَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ لَهُ أَجْرُ خَمْسِينَ مِنْكُمْ. Those who manage to stick and to hold firmly onto the religion of Allah Azza wa Jal and to follow the straight path that you are following, then every one of them will be rewarded a reward that's equal to the reward of 50 people of you. They said, Ya Rasul, Ya Nabi Allah, Al Minhum. They wanted to inquire, to clarify. I think you meant from them, not from us. They have the reward of 50 people from them, not from us as companions. The Prophet ﷺ confirmed and said, Bal minkum. Yes, I meant what I said. They will be rewarded, the reward of 50 people from you. Why? Because أَنَّكُمْ تَجِدُونَ عَلَى الْخَيْرِ أَعْوَانًا وَهُمْ لَا يَجِدُونَ. You can find others around who can help you with the good things that you want to do. But at that moment of time, at that period of time, these people will be lacking help, lacking support. They will not be so many people around to help or to motivate them to do good things. So if you encourage yourself and encourage others around to follow the straight path of the Prophet and his companions, the rewards will be even greater than that of the companions themselves. And just not to be misunderstood in the end, I'm not saying that some of us or anybody of us Sahaba would be better than them generally speaking, no. Because these people are the first generation, they went through a very hustling process just to practice their Islam. And also, they accompanied the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ajr al-Suhbah, so they, even if you do more, they will still excel you in this particular thing to accompany the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is something that we can't share with them. We can share them the reward, we can share the benefits of the hijrah, we can share lots of the good things that they have done, but not the company of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah ta'ala grant us the company of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we have missed in this world and the hereafter. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alamin. Last but not least, I would like to remind you of the start of our Obey Quran school at Hala, inshallah, Azza wa Jal, next week. The first day will be Monday, inshallah, Azza wa Jal, from 5 to 7. It's an after school that's meant for teaching our children Al-Qur'an al-Kareem, just Al-Qur'an al-Kareem, not to confuse it with the other school. The weekend school is about Arabic and Islamic studies and other things, but this school will be focused only on Al-Qur'an, teaching Al-Qur'an al-Kareem, teaching Al-Qur'an al-Kareem and how to recite it properly and al-Ahkam and all these things. So just a reminder for the parents who have already registered their children to make sure they bring them in time, inshallah. It's Monday, Tuesday and Thursday. Monday, Tuesday and Thursday from 5 to 7 p.m. inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a success and to help us teach our children Al-Qur'an al-Kareem. Allahumma ja'al al-Qur'ana fina wa fi ahlina اللهم علمنا منه ما اللهم علمنا منه ما جهلنا وذكرنا منه ما نسينا أو نسينا اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك اللهم انفعنا ببركات الهجرة وارزقنا ثواب الهجرة اللهم إنا قد حرمنا صحبة المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم في الدنيا فلا تحرمنا صحبته في الآخرة في الجنة يا رب العالمين اللهم إنا قد حرمنا الهجرة معه صلى الله عليه وسلم فلا تحرمنا أجر الهجرة يا رب العالمين اللهم أعنا على ترك المعاصي وأعنا على فعل الطاعات وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك اللهم ارحم عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم ارحم عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصر عبادك المظلومين في كل مكان وأيدهم بنصرك وتأييدك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وأقم الصلاة.